G'day YouTube, hello subscribers. Down in the comms hut here, and I'm building a MOSFET linear amplifier for the HF band, and I'm choosing a transmission line transformer made of coax cable for the output. It's becoming more and more popular. We're seeing it in broadcast use and various other applications, so I thought, hey, let's do it. I haven't seen many videos out there, and here it is. It looks really complex, but it's really not. I'll provide circuits later on in this video. And a lot of people get turned off because the coax that's used in these is around about 25 or 20 ohms, and people have trouble obtaining it easily and at a cheap price. And I've chosen, just for this experiment, to actually make it. I'll provide a link later on to my one of my videos, and or you can look it up on the channel, and you'll see how I've actually made the coax cable. It's not difficult at all. This whole arrangement costs probably under $20 to put together. So let's have a look at how it all comes together, how it's tested, and more or less how it works. Okay, so let's put these balun's, these coaxial transmission line transformers together. And it's just as easy as getting your ferrite cores. I've purchased these from Electus Distribution or J-Car. They're an LO1238. They're about $6 for the pair, nice and cheap. And it's just a matter of simply holding two together and then grabbing your 20 ohm coax that you've made. And I know there's going to be some naysayers out there and says, oh, you can't use that homemade coax because it doesn't have a Teflon center and all the rest of it. Well, you know, if you can get a Teflon center, that's nice and easy. Or if you want to pay the money for it, that's fine. But I've oversized the center conductor, and I've been very conservative on my usage of these balun's. So I'm just winding now. And away we go. That's two, that's three, and that's the fourth one. That's as easy as that. You might want to just reduce that length just a little bit, so you don't waste any of your precious homemade coax there. And that's as easy as that. You make another one of those, probably tighten it up, squish it up a little bit better, and wire it up, either if you want it to be a 1-4 or 1-9 transformer as per the diagram. So that's as easy as it is. I can't stress how simple it is. You just wire it up accordingly. Let's now have a look at how we test it. Okay, there's more than one way to test balun's, and I'll just go through the way I'm testing it. It's not necessarily the best, and I'll explain why. Here's our spectrum analyzer with tracking generator, and here's our output, which is 50 ohms, going into the 50 ohm balun under test. But here we've got Z low, which is our low impedance output, which I'm then connecting back into the 50 ohm spectrum analyzer to show the waveform, what's coming out of here. And probably the better way of doing it would be to have two identical balun's. So you basically then would connect your 12.5 or 12 or 5 ohm low side to the other back-to-back 12 or 5 ohm of the other adjacent balun. And then from the 50 ohm, you'd go back into the spectrum analyzer and then deduct the losses or halve the loss. And that's probably a more accurate depiction. Another way you can basically do it is quite easy at home, is using your transceiver. There we go, we're focused. Use your transceiver, and these are a good reason you might want to modify a HF transceiver for broadband to do exactly these type of tests. Then you've got 50 ohms out here, 50 ohms into your VSWR meter, your bridge, whatever, and then from the output, your antenna out, you then connect your balun, which is also 50 ohms, which you then will connect your terminating resistor on that balun. be it 300 ohms, whatever your balun may be. If it's a 3-to-1, if it's a 4-to-1, 6-to-1, 9-to-1, whatever it may be, you put your appropriate terminating load right here, and that way you'll be able to then do a bandwidth chart. Okay, here's the 4-to-1 balun, and I'm going to be checking for the bandwidth and see how well it performs. And here's basically my 50 ohm input side. You can see it's bridged there and goes into both sides, the left and right here, and crosses over here. Try and get a better visual. And I'm just simply tapping straight off the low side. And I mentioned before, it's probably not the best way to do it, and then that goes up into the analyzer, and of course the tracking generator comes out, snakes around, and there we are. So we'll just have a look and see what's happening on the tracking gen, and I've got it calibrated, and look at that, what a fantastic bandwidth. I've just got my marker on, and let's just have a look. Try and get a better... you sort of get the idea. I'm trying to get a better shot of it. Not there. There we go. It's probably about the best I can get it there. And I'm just going to cruise my marker across. And it starts off at... really, it's about 800 kilohertz. It's about a dB, 2 dB down. And at 1 megahertz, it's about 1.6 dB of loss. And I'll just cruise across. Look at that. And it drops down a little bit to 2.2 dB on 12 megahertz. But all in all, very flat performance all the way through. And up on 6 meters, that's about 3 dB down. So for the output of my amplifier, I'm going to expect a little bit, need to give a little bit more drive on the input side if it's also doing the same thing with the balun there, if it's tapering off. I expect it will with this material, but all in all, I'm very pleased with just junkyard parts. Now, I know a lot of you are going to say, but that's all very well, and I'd like to test it that way, but I don't have a spectrum analyzer. My wife is not going to let me buy one. I just can't justify it, and I can't sell it to her. That's fine. Don't panic. Now, just for you, I'm going to test it without the spectrum analyzer, and in my opinion, this is just as good, if not an excellent way as well to test transmission line transformers or any balun that you want to do. Notice I've got it configured in the 9-to-1 configuration, so I've got my crossovers here, and I've got a 5.6 ohm resistor. 5.6 multiplied by 9 is going to give us 50 ohms, and basically just try and show you the wiring setup there. And I've got about 800-900 picofarads across here. That's the secret there. And basically four turns of the 20 ohm coax, and basically straight into my VSWR meter. No surprises, no tricks there. And basically got my transceiver. There's another reason you might want to modify your transceiver for wideband to check wideband transceiver balance and so forth. So let's now I can hit the transmit key. I'll just use my my PTT here remotely, and I'll just go down and try and I'll go to calibrate, get a little bit more power, and that's probably a bit too much. And I'll hit calibrate, and I'll flip back to VSWR, and there you go. I'm pressing. Probably a good way if I do that, and then flick it to reflected. Perfect. 14 megahertz, good old 20 meter band. And I'll hit. I have to turn my power down. Don't want to burn out my load resistors. There we go. Now hit reflect. There you go. 1.1 to 1 on 20 meters. Gee, this 29, just on 30 megahertz. I'd like to go to 6 meters, but this radio doesn't do it. I'll go to calibrate. I'll try and get the focus for you. It's not going to focus. That's aggravating. Anyway, I'll just hit forward, calibrate. There we go, it's focused nicely. Reflect, 1.1 to 1. Well, there you have it. Transmission line transformers made with homemade coax cable and locally sourced ferrite cores. What a beauty. If you've liked this video, please give me a thumbs up. It's very encouraging to get one or two every now and again. And if you've got some useful rants, please write it in the text box down there. I'd love to hear what you've got to say. And if you'd like to know a lot more about transmission line transformers, I've got a lot of value and knowledge from the references at the end of this video. If you have a look at the journal articles and application notes, you'll be able to get a lot more detailed information that that you might like when constructing these. So I definitely learnt a lot from them. Okay, as always, thanks for watching and stay tuned.